Well, this is a little bit of a seductive pose.
Welcome back, everybody. Welcome to Shill Brothers Outdoors. My name is Kevin. We got a tent video today, so you know what that means. Andy's probably sitting this one out. Make sure you click that subscribe button and click that bell notification if you want to know when we do our live streams, because we do a lot of live streams. Also, if you're interested in some Shill Brothers merch, I'll put the link down below. Check that out. Today we're talking about tents and about how you can get the best night of sleep in a tent. And yes, it's possible, even though those hammock campers might say otherwise. If you've been watching this channel for a while, you know that Andy and I, we do a lot of hammock camping. In fact, Andy has been primarily a hammock camper for the last like 5 years. I kind of am a tweener. I go back and forth. Hammock camping certainly has its place. I still hammock camp. I have multiple hammock setups, but there are situations where a tent is superior and can be the better shelter choice. I've been sleeping in a tent since 2009, and there are some intricacies to it, and you can have a terrible night's sleep in a tent. But this video, we're gonna go through my tips for how you can get the best night's sleep. And let's get outside.
There we go, much better. A little more room to move my hands around. Before I get into the tips, I do wanna talk a little bit about sleeping in a hammock versus sleeping in a tent. And I will say, if you are someone who is a like dedicated back sleeper, which I am not, sleeping in a hammock might be the thing to do, but most people are not fully dedicated back sleepers. You know, we got side sleepers, stomach sleepers, and people who roll around, but a hammock setup is really good for a back sleeper. I don't think a hammock is an end-all be-all for a lot of people. A lot of people who sleep in a hammock will say it is without a doubt the best shelter to sleep in. It's an awesome shelter and it has its place, but there are certainly a lot of people who like tents. Another thing we talk a lot about in this channel is invest in sleep. You know, sleep is crucial when you're out in the backcountry. When you're doing like multi-day, multi-mile, repetitive kind of trips where you're grinding down your body, sleep is crucial. And there is literally nothing worse than just getting a terrible night's sleep and then having to crush miles the next day. So regardless of anything that you take from this video, please invest in sleep. A big theme for this video is you want to try and replicate how you sleep at home as much as you can. That is going to give you the best night's sleep in a tent. So if you sleep on your side, plan on being a side sleeper. If you sleep on your stomach, plan on sleeping on your stomach. If you need to bring multiple pillows, bring multiple pillows. One thing that has changed for me sleeping in a tent is I bring a legit pillow. This is a Nemo Philo, a luxury pillow. It's big, it weighs like half a pound. You know, it rolls up to like this big. It's one of the biggest pillows you can get, but I found that I need a good pillow to sleep on the ground, and in a hammock you don't really need that. So a common theme throughout this video is we want to try and replicate how you're sleeping at home and put that and infuse that into a tent setup. First, let's talk about what tent you might want to use. Now, if you're someone who's going out in the winter, who does a lot of cold weather camping or wet camping, you might want to get a double layer tent. You know, this is a Z-Pax Ultiplex. It's a great tent. It's a single layer tent though, and you can get condensation inside here, and that's gonna ruin your sleeping experience if you've got water dripping down on you the whole time. So first tip, make sure you get the right tent. Get a double wall tent if you need to, get a winter tent if you need to. If you're constantly going with another person, probably get a three person tent. Personally, the Z-Pax Ultiplex is literally like the only one person tent. I kind of call it a one and a half person tent. It's the only one person tent I've found that can really fit me. I mean, I'm a big dude. Most people like two person tents. Get a good tent, get one that fits you, and get a double layer one if you need to, and get a four seasons one if you need to. But doing all of those will give you a great experience. And you don't need to spend a ton of money. I mean, you can get these trekking pole tents like from Tarp Tent, a couple hundred bucks. And then if you really want to ball out, get yourself a Z-Pax or a Hyperlite Mountain Gear, or you know, any of those great Dyneema cottage vendors. Airflow is also a good consideration with a tent. You know, like I said, if you're going somewhere that's wet, you're gonna want airflow. So the Z-Pax tents do a good job with that, especially something like the Duplex where you get both sides. But airflow is a consideration when you're in a tent. Not something you really have to worry about in a hammock, but make sure you get a tent. If you're someone who needs a lot of airflow, it's totally gonna depend on the conditions you're tent camping in, but take that into consideration when you purchase a tent. All right, you've got your tent dialed in, you know which one you want to use. Next, and I will tell you, might be the most crucial thing for me in getting a good night's sleep is the air mattress. There are so many air mattresses to choose from. Sea to Summit, Big Agnes, Thermarest, Nemo. I've probably owned 5 or 6 different air mattresses. I currently own 3. I have some for cold weather, but I have found that without a doubt, the thing determining whether I get the best night's sleep is the air mattress. And because I sleep on my side, and if you sleep on your side, you need a thick one. I'm talking 3 or 4 inches. Finding the right air mattress for me, and I need a 4-inch pad. So what I'm using right now is a Thermarest Topo Lux 4-inch pad, and I'll inflate it all the way and then let out a little bit of air. So it's kind of like a 3.75-inch pad, but without a doubt, air mattress is crucial. Make sure you try and test it out before you buy one if you can. That's why REI is a great place to do that. You can go there, they've got all the models, you can lay on them, but air mattress is crucial. Make sure you get a good one, and make sure you never forget to bring that patch kit. Next, we kind of already talked about it, pillow, crucial. I know people who bring multiple pillows. I've tried out like 5 different pillows. I need pillow. I mean, if you sleep on your side, you've got this space right here. You need to put something there. You're probably gonna need a bigger pillow. Side sleeping is just requires a heavier setup for me to be comfortable. I need a thicker pillow, I need a thicker pad, but a good consideration is a good pillow. You just don't wanna wake up with some neck crank in there. It's the worst. So make sure you get a good pillow. Okay, let's talk about your insulation, because for a lot of people, this is gonna be super important. I'm not gonna talk about temperature ratings, you know, pick the rating that you're gonna use the most and try to be a little bit conservative. If you're someone who only backpacks in the summer, you could get by with a Costco quilt. If you're someone who does a lot of winter backpacking, you might wanna consider a 0-degree setup. One thing I will say, and I preach this, I'm a fan of sleeping bags in colder climates. I don't like quilts when it's cold out. I roll around, some slit opens up and I get freaking cold. I am a fan of sleeping bags, and I tell most people, you might wanna consider starting with a sleeping bag. It can make the tent setup much more comfortable. Not something you need to worry about in a hammock. In a hammock, you can use a top quilt and you're fine. But I greatly, greatly appreciate a sleeping bag when I'm sleeping on the ground. And it is something I've found, you know, in addition to the pillow, in addition to the sleeping pad, that really makes a better night's sleep for me. If I can roll around in that thing and I don't have air slits coming out, I'm a much happier camper. Another thing I do to replicate my sleeping at home is I take my phone with me on every trip and I play white noise. That's something you might wanna consider. I don't do it in the peak summer because I love the sound of bugs and the cicadas. I love that. I actually prefer that over white noise, but in the winter or like late fall, when it's like dead quiet and you hear like, you're gonna hear that? And you're like, oh my God, it's a bear. It's probably a mouse. But white noise, if you listen to it at home, bring it in your tent. People always ask me all the time, do you use a footprint with your tent? I don't. This won't play into whether you get a better night's sleep or not, but people always ask me like, do you need a footprint? Is that crucial? No. And lastly, in terms of like what you can do to ensure you get a really good night's sleep, you want level ground. I know this is obvious. You want level ground, and then as you can see here, you want pine straw if you can. Pine straw is without a doubt the most comfortable thing to lay on, to put your bag on. You know, snow's not bad too, but flat pine straw is the best, and I can't tell you how big of a deal having flat ground is. And obviously you can't always do that, but do the best you can. And if you're on a little bit of an unevenness, one thing you can do, which really helps me, is put your head up on the higher side. That helps me a lot. It is super annoying to like slide down when you're sleeping, but put your head on the higher side. That's a little tip that'll probably help. So in summary, the best way to get the best night's sleep in a tent is simulate your home sleeping conditions as much as you can. For me, I'm a side sleeper. I need a 4-inch pad, I need a big pillow, and I prefer a sleeping bag. It's gonna be different for everybody. If you're someone who loves sleeping on your back and you hate sleeping in a tent, you might wanna try a hammock. And then make sure you have the right tent. That can be a one person, a two person, something that's got a lot of airflow, something that's freestanding if you don't want to deal with trekking poles, but make sure you have the right tent. We've kind of already talked about the reasoning for getting certain tents. And then yeah, you just want some good, soft, flat ground. And oh, it's the best. So that is it. Those are my tips. Sleeping in a tent can be very comfortable. Some people don't think so, but you can get a great night's sleep in a tent, and there's nothing better than waking up after doing 15 plus miles and just feeling great and not sore and being ready for the next day. So utilize those tips and you can sleep great in a tent.